Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video, we're going to use the payment function in Excel 365 to compare 15-year mortgages and 30-year mortgages. All right, so students in CIS 120 are working on Excel basics, and the payment function is a great one to play around with because it's pretty easy to use, and it also has a lot of real-world application. And you can see I've already got a spreadsheet kind of set up here with some labels. And let's go ahead and fill in some of this information. So for instance, monthly take-home pay, we'll just play around with a number and I'll put in 6,000. And I'm gonna use kind of a Dave Ramsey philosophy and that your mortgage payment, your house payment, your rent payment shouldn't be more than 25% of your take-home pay. So let's figure out what 25% of that particular sale value is. And I'll just simply multiply it by 0.25 and there we go. So for a $6,000 a month take-home pay, we should roughly be trying to get a housing payment of around $1,500. So let's go ahead and put in some standard pieces of information. So for house prices, I'll put down $340,000. For down payment, I'm gonna put down $60,000. And for loan amount, don't do the math in your head, equals house price minus the down payment. That's going to get our result. I'm going to go ahead and select these and turn them all into some currency, US dollars, and I'm going to hide a couple decimal places so that I don't see those. Okay, so basically going to be borrowing $280,000. Now, each of these calculators is going to reference some of that information. Now, I can go ahead and plug this in. For each one, I can do 30 years and 15 years. That'll be easy. The rate's going to vary. Generally, the rates for a 30-year mortgage are going to be a little bit higher than a 15-year mortgage. I'm going to go ahead and put down 3.9% for the 30, and maybe I'll put 2.5% for the 15. Might be able to find them a little bit lower, depending on credit scores and stuff like that. Now, here's where the work really is going to start. I'm going to calculate those monthly payments. Equals, and I'm going to use the PMT function. And I'm going to be using the three core arguments, rate, number of periods, and present value. So the rate is going to be the mortgage rate divided by 12 to get monthly terms, comma. Number of periods is going to be the cell that contains the number of years times 12 to get it into months. Everything needs to be in months for a mortgage, for a monthly compounding loan. So I'm taking the annual rate divided by 12 to get a monthly rate, and I'm taking the number of years times 12 to get the number of months in the loan, comma. Present value, negative version of the loan amount. Very, very important. Negative version of the loan amount. And then I'm gonna do a closing parentheses, press enter. That calculates the payment at 13,2067. Great. What's the total paid? That's gonna be equal to my monthly payments times number of years times 12 months per year plus that down payment. Every monthly check you had to write plus that down payment, that's the total paid. What's the finance cost? Finance cost is what you had to pay above and beyond the price of the house. That's going to be equal to the total paid minus the price of the house. Okay, so because we borrowed money, we had to pay more than the price of the house. About 200 grand extra. Of course, this is over 30 years. Now let's do the same thing for 15-year mortgage. By the way, we could have written this function so that we could just copy and paste it over. But when you're first practicing Excel, I want you to redo work. You know, a little repetition is going to be good for you. So let's try it again. Monthly payment for the 15-year mortgage equals PMT parentheses, the rate, annual rate for the loan divided by 12, annual rate divided by 12, comma, number of payment periods, that's going to be the number of years, times 12, how many months are in that 15 years? And then comma, and then the present value is a negative version of the loan amount. Why a negative? If we don't do that negative, I'll show you this, if I just do a positive of the loan amount, it's going to show our monthly payment as a negative, as a cash outflow, which is technically correct. And the business department would like me to show you the payment function this way, because the money that you pay is a cash outflow. It should be expressed as a negative. However, it doesn't look as user-friendly. So by putting a minus sign in front of the PMT function, we can display that as a positive. Or what I typically do, I put a minus sign in front of that loan amount. And that expresses it as a positive. So I just think it looks better that way to see the number in a positive format. But if you're a business student, you do need to be prepared that money that you pay is a cash outflow, often expressed as a negative. Money that you receive, even a loan, is a cash inflow, and that's a positive. Okay, total paid, same thing we did before, equals monthly payment times the number of years we paid it times 12 months per year plus that original down payment. Don't forget that down payment. There's our total paid. Cost of finance is going to be equal to the total paid minus the house price, not the loan amount, the house price there. There we go. And now we can start to really make an honest comparison. Let me just bold these monthly payments. And so for a 15-year mortgage, our monthly payment is going to exceed our 25% of take-home pay, because our 25% of take-home pay is $1,500. 15-year mortgage payment is almost $1,900. 30-year mortgage is a little over $1,300, so definitely a cheaper, lower payment. However, here's the real savings. 15-year mortgage, since you're financing it over a shorter period of time, and of course you're getting a lower interest rate, the finance cost is only $56,000 over the price of the house, as opposed to $200,000 over the price of the house. So although you're paying a little bit more per month, you've got that higher payment to deal with over the longer term, paying off that house sooner rather than later. Now, if this kind of monthly payment scares you, then of course a lot of people will advise, well, go for the 30-year, but just pay it off like a 15, which you can certainly do. If you were to make 13 payments a year on a 30-year mortgage, it typically pays off in about 18 months or so. And we can prove that later with an amortization table. But generally, if you make just one extra payment a year, that 30-year mortgage gets paid off in 18 years. And of course, if you have a 30-year mortgage and you end up paying $1,900 a month, it will pay off in 15 years or less, like a 15-year mortgage. So interesting. And there's our payment function used to compare two common terms for a mortgage. Thanks for hanging out with me.